Okay, here's how I make myself look like a guy. I try to keep my skin as natural as possible, but I do cover my acne. I also make my lips smaller and like crusty. I take a concealer that's too light for my skin, and I really define my bone structure. And the most important part is contouring. Pretty much contour here, here, and my jawline. You're really gonna want to contour your jawline and blend it. I contour my nose to be long and thin. Another important part is shading right next to your eye. And I define my butt chin. I bring my eyebrows down and I make them more boxy. I tie my hair in a bun in the back, and I bobby pin pretty much the entire front part of my hair. And then I take this little curling wand and just kind of like curl the front pieces. And then you kind of just keep teasing and curling until it looks legit. Once you throw a hood or a beanie on, it looks pretty decent from afar. I forgot to do my eye bags. Now you kind of just have to act like a guy. Don't smile, just smirk.
Okay, so story time. So let's start from the beginning. It was Monday, 8 in the morning. I'd just come from an amazing weekend, literally slept all day. By the way, I was in the 6th grade. Anyways, I was in my first period class and I met this kid. We talked for the whole period, talking about random things like memes and TikTok. Then the end of class came by, and out of nowhere, he started threatening me, saying, "Oh, if you don't become my girlfriend, I'm going to kill myself." Yeah. When he said that, I looked at him in shock. Thank God for the bell that rang. I got up and went to my next period class. I tried to avoid him as much as possible. I was lucky enough that I didn't have any other classes with him. So I finished that day and I got home and ate dinner, hanged out with my family, and did some homework. Then this is where it got weird. I went to bed and...
So there's this customer that comes into my store probably like once or twice a week. He works with a program called Instacart. He basically buys people's groceries for them so they don't have to leave the house, and he delivers them to them. So we're having a conversation at my register one day, and he made a gross sexual comment. It gave me very much pedophile vibes, and I was like, relax. And he was like, "Oh, no, like, I'm just joking. I joke with all the girls here like that." I don't know if it's because I watch too much TV, but that shit didn't sound right. My spidey senses tingling off the charts. I was like, this dude is a fucking weirdo. If you're a rewards member at my store, your name comes up on my computer screen when you type in your phone number. So being that the sex offender database is public information, I went out on a limb here, and what naturally occurred to me in my big old badonga was to look up his name. And what happened when I looked up his name? Sex offender. Yeah, how's he an Instacart worker?
This boy lied about his age just to date me. Story time. So back when my cute self was a senior in high school, there was this new girl that came to our school. Long story short, me and her ended up becoming super close. I went to her house, spent the night, her family loved me. I mean, why wouldn't they? Anyways, she had a brother. We're gonna call him Binky. Me and Binky got pretty close. Now I want you guys to keep in mind, Binky didn't go to my school because their parents were divorced. So the sister who I was friends with lived with her mom, and Binky lived with his dad who lived in another city. But sometimes Binky would go to his mom's house, which is how I met him. Now that we got that out of the way, as me and Binky were getting closer, one day he asked me, "Hey, how old are you?" And I was like, "Oh, I just turned 17. How about you?" He told me, "Oh, I'm 17 too, but my 18th birthday is coming up." After a while, me and him eventually started dating. Then one day, I ran into his cousin, who happened to go to my school. The rest of this story is crazy!
Hi guys, back with another Get Ready With Me and doing what you guys have requested.
There were literally 1,100 likes!
Since y'all want the avocado, mama gonna give you the avocado.
And since we just reached 500,000 followers, this one's dedicated to you guys. Speaking of avocados, do you guys want to know something funny about avocados? The first time I tried an avocado, I was like 5 or 6, I think, and I went to my friend's house. She had an avocado tree, but it didn't look like an avocado tree. It looked like there were big fat toads hanging from that thing. Anywho, when we got inside, her family started meshing up those big green things. And they were eating them, and they wanted me to try them. Well, I did it. Then I ended up in the ER, and that is how I found out I was allergic to avocados.
Now we're done. This is the completed look. Thank you guys so much for 500,000. I love you all. Until next time.
Back with another Get Ready With Me. The first thing we're going to do for this look is glue down our brows, like so. And then cover it in white powder.
Oh my. I'm covering your face. You can cover it any way you want. I like to do mine in dots.
Blend, 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 blend.
Don't forget the blush. Now it comes to drawing the design. Make sure you put random shapes all over your face. Then begin tracing those outlines. Draw more shapes.
And more shapes.
This is the look with the black light. So I was a little dummy and forgot to record a video of me completing this look, but at least I got a picture. Thanks for watching. Until next time. Hey guys, we're back at it with another Get Ready With Me. The first thing I did was apply my brows off camera, but next I'm going to apply my foundation. Now that we have all this foundation, it's time to apply it. Treasure. But I've never met in any other treasures before, so where are all my treasures at? I know you're out there. Now I'm drawing these red weird line things. Next, start shaping out your face. So this is the general shape that I'm looking for. Next, we're going to begin painting. We're done painting. Time to draw the details. The deets are done. Time to shade. We're shading. Thanks for watching. Until next time, back with another Get Ready With Me. Today we're going to be doing the iconic James Charles's bubbly look. We're going to start off this look by adding some eye primer and doing these eyelids first. First, we are dipping into our baby blue, then applying it to our eyelid. Now purple, then your lid, the pink, and again the lid. Now that we've wiped off all the old primer, it's time to apply a new cut crease. Now that we've cut our crease, I'm going to press white shadow all over my lid. Now we're going to apply some white eyeliner. Now for some black eyeliner. Also, don't mind my voice. I'm a wee bit sick. Now contouring with the purple. Applying the blue. Pink. Some highlight. Time to draw our bubbles. Once all the bubbles are drawn, fill them. Now that the bubbles are filled, we're going to outline them. Adding the last details. And this is the completed look. Thanks for watching. Until next time.
If me and my sister ever put our elbows on the dinner table, my mom would take a fork and stab us in the arm. On Thanksgiving, I put my elbow on the table and she stabbed me with the fork. And she told me I wasn't allowed to have Thanksgiving dinner that night and I had to go to my room. Well, payback's a bitch. My mom got food poisoning from the turkey because she accidentally baked it with the plastic in it. But guess who didn't get food poisoning because they didn't eat the turkey? That's what you get, bitch.
A Wednesday in elementary school, it was lunchtime. A bitch had to go potty. It was poo-poo time. So I remember I went to the restroom and I was exploding or whatever. And these girls walked in. We're gonna call them the Chipettes, okay? This is the best part. The Chipettes start yelling in the bathroom. Is someone here? Can someone hear me? Like, I didn't say anything. I was literally taking a shit. Like, what? These girls, deadass, start laughing. They turn off the lights in the bathroom. They turn on all the sinks, whatever. And they start saying, like, Bloody Mary or some shit. And then the Chipettes run out of the bathroom and shut the door. So here I am, getting casted on. I remember seeing a shadow. I fell on my ass. And I start screaming and crying. It wasn't good. So someone called the janitor. Janitor walks in to check up on me. It's a guy.
Story time of how my boyfriend ended up being my stepdad. So I was dating this kid, and me and this kid had, like, the best relationship. He was 19, and I was 17. And, I mean, we were literally always together. And my mom would always call him hot and stuff like that, but, you know, I thought that's just what moms do. And I didn't think of it in that type of way. So one day, my boyfriend got mad at me. And he was like, I'm gonna F your mom, become your stepdad, and boss you around if you keep...